Hey, what's up, garden friends? How's everybody doing? I hope you're good. I am great. For another Fern Friday, or whenever you're watching this. This week, I want to talk about the Lemon Button Fern, which is the Nephrolepsis cordifolia, also known as the Duffy Fern and Fishbone Fern, I believe. Yeah. They aren't looking too hot, are they? I could have very easily gone through, trimmed these guys up, made them look really pretty for the video. The whole point, the whole reason I wanted to do the Fern Friday was so that there could be conversations, so that troubleshooting could happen. And I think that there's more of a learning experience talking about what went wrong here. And I can tell you exactly what went wrong. For starters, these are sopping wet and they haven't been watered in, it's been about a week. So the soil they're in is retaining way too much moisture. The Lemon Button Fern, just like most other ferns that are grown as houseplants, they want a moist soil, but they don't want to be sopping wet. I don't want to dry out for too long either. And that's why ferns are sort of a pain. And then the other problem, how all of this dead foliage is on the outside here on both of them. Where I had these guys set up over here on my grow table, they were kind of surrounded, a little bit too packed in. So that's no good. They were wet and there wasn't much airflow around them. That's why it's the foliage that's mostly on the outside that's not looking great. That's all right. They're somewhat forgiving. I can fix them up. And so for starters, I'm just going to come on in and I'm just going to start snipping out all the dead foliage. Good practice with houseplants to not leave the dead stuff in there. The dead foliage, that can attract pests and disease. Now, since some of it is kind of in there somewhat densely, I may not be able to get all of it, but I'd like to get the majority of it, and I'm cutting it as close to the crown as I can. And there's the carnage. Not too bad. This looks so much better now. What a difference that made. Okay. Yeah, the Lemon Button Fern. Oh, sorry, kitty. These do make a decent houseplant as far as ferns are concerned. They only get 10 to 12 inches tall, which is one of the things that's nice about them. Other ferns like the Boston ferns, the macho ferns, lots of others that are sold as houseplants can get kind of large. But 10 to 12 inches, that's much more manageable and also makes them excellent for terrarium use, which I think I'm gonna do, probably in this video. They are non-toxic to both dogs and cats and horses. All according to ASPCA website. I don't know about kids. Guys, I don't really like to say whether or not a plant is toxic to children or to humans just because it's like, what if I'm wrong? What if everything I read is outdated or something and it's just too much pressure for me. Don't eat your plants. So one of the reasons I'm told and have read in some places that they're called lemon button ferns is because supposedly if you take their little pieces of their fronds off, these little round bits, and crush it up in your fingers, it's supposed to smell lemony. No, I didn't smell anything. Didn't notice a hint of lemon. Outdoors, lemon buttons are hardy zones 8 and up, which is nice. Actually, a lot of the other ferns I've talked about have been zone 10 and up. So they're frost tender. They'll probably die back if you live in zone 8 and have a really hard freeze, but that doesn't mean they won't come back for you. Probably just go ahead and dump a bunch of mulch on top of them, keep those roots, the rhizomes, as a crown alive. And I bet it would bounce back. Indoors, normal household temperatures are fantastic, anywhere from like 68 to 74. They'll do well with that. It is always important to remember, however, that the more cool the conditions, the less often you're probably going to need to water. The same thing with the amount of light the plant gets. If it's not getting very much light, then you're not going to need to water it as much. But it's always best with ferns to base where they need watering off of how the soil feels. If it feels dry, water as soon as possible. They don't like to dry out. In my first Fern Friday video on the maidenhair ferns, I talked about just moisture and humidity loving plants. And I tried to show a difference between soggy soil versus moist soil, as well as using a tray or a drainage dish full of pebbles to increase the humidity around the plant. Because the more humidity, really the better, just the easier. That's pretty much the case for most ferns. There are exceptions, bird's nest ferns, blue star ferns, the kangaroo paw ferns. There are several out there that don't have to have really, really humid conditions, but it just makes life easier. And of course, daily mistings, that makes a really big difference. Mist the surface of the soil as well as the foliage, let that drip down. You can do anything from once to twice a day. Main thing is that you want to allow time for water to dry out in between those mists within the crown. You can have some problems if water starts collecting in there and there's not enough airflow to dry that back out, and end up with some crown rot and very unhappy with really dead plant. Just like with all the other ferns, their roots tend to be kind of delicate, so I would say fertilize during the growing season, which is typically late spring through late summer. Really when you notice that the fern is growing, that's the active growing season. Use a half strength to quarter strength fertilizer. If you're going to fertilize weekly, I would go with a quarter strength. If you're going to fertilize monthly, I would use a half strength, just to be safe. Don't want to burn those delicate little roots. Why are they showing you the foliage when I'm talking about the roots? And you know, I mentioned these are great for terrariums, and it's something I've been thinking about doing with these guys. I'm gonna go ahead and do it. because I already have all my supplies sitting out from throwing this terrarium together, so why not? It's not gonna be anything crazy fancy. It's pretty much gonna be very similar to what I did over here. Oh, for starters, got a great big bowl here and lots of reflection. I'm gonna go ahead and pour some hydrostone in the bottom just to create a false bottom that the water can collect and not be in contact with the soil. Now I have some screening here, just some plastic window screening. I'm gonna go ahead and throw that on top of there. And that's just to keep the soil from washing through into that false bottom. I'm going to do a thin layer of charcoal on top of that. That is going to clean the water as it moves through there. And I'm just using horticultural charcoal here. Activated carbon would also work well. It'd be kind of pricey because it's made for fish tanks. And go ahead and level that out. I usually prefer to rinse my carbon and charcoal until the water runs clear. That way, dusty, murky water doesn't end up settling in the bottom. I'm also kind of just in like go mode right now. So I was like, you know what? I'm not too worried about it. It's fine. And now I'm putting in some terrarium soil. This is actually a reptile soil made for, well, terrariums for frogs and lizards. It's nice and sandy, so I think it'll work well for this. And again, gonna level that back out. I probably should have moistened it beforehand. Now I'm gonna go ahead and pull these out of their pots, see what's going on in here. They aren't rooted in too heavily, but that soil is very damp, so I'm gonna go ahead and work out the majority of that soil, probably. Dig out a little hole and drop them on in there. I went ahead and I top dressed this, and that's pretty much all there is to it. I did end up just going with the one fern. I don't think that two of them would have looked quite right in this. This is also a very large and kind of dramatic bowl for something like this. Ultimately, what I actually wanted to do here was to plant Fittonia around this, but they were about the same size, so it would have caused the same problem with not having enough airflow around everything. I don't think it would have worked out quite right. I'm gonna go ahead, let this grow out some more, and then I'll put those Fittonias in there. I also forgot something very important, which is that when using the reptile soil, the soil that's made for terrariums and vivariums and whatnot, you need to soak it beforehand. I have forgotten with my last two terrariums to soak the soil first, but it's really important with this reptile soil. And the reason for that is you can see this pooling in here. It takes it a while to absorb water the first time. So yeah, I screwed up on that one. It'll be okay though. It'll soak it all up. There we go. Went ahead and overexposed this a little bit, make it easier to see. It's also just barely short on gravel, but that's actually okay. Typically a bowl like this with such a wide opening in the top is really better for planting up with cactus and succulents in a terrarium because it's going to have more airflow in it. Something with a really wide top like this is going to let out a lot of humidity. So by having that layer of gravel in there, that's gonna help hold in some of that moisture a little bit longer. That's it though. Nothing crazy, super simple. I actually do like the simplicity of it. If I can find some more gravel that matches this, I'll probably go ahead and put that in here. Could also top dress this with some moss, with the top being really big and open. I didn't really feel like doing that. I just figured the moss would dry out kind of quickly, but there are preserved mosses that would work well also. But that's that. That's really it. The lemon button fern, super easy to grow. It's a nice small fern, great for terrariums, great to have inside of like reptile enclosures or amphibian enclosures because of that smaller size. Low to medium indirect light, high moisture. Don't let it dry out for too long. By for too long, I mean like the top inch or so of soil. Like once that's dry, water it. Definitely do a lot better that way. This looks like garbage. I like it. I wanted it to look really simple, but I really would like for it to have some more gravel in it. And then once the fronds of the ferns perk back up too, that's going to make a big difference. What are some of your guys' experience with the lemon button fern? We'll point a fern Friday. Talk about our ferns. You can put that in the comments down below, or I have all my social media linked down below in the description. I use Instagram far more than anything else, and I'll follow you back. It's a lot of fun seeing each other's pictures and seeing what's going on with everybody's gardens. It's fun being plant nerds together. Hey, and hitting that thumbs up makes a big difference for the videos and for the channel. I really do appreciate it. And subscribe also, because I upload multiple times a week. So hit that notification bell, that way you know new videos come out. I hope everybody's doing well, having a great day, great night, whenever you're watching this. Overall, that life is just beautiful for you. As always, most importantly, everybody, keep on growing. Bye-bye.